What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. In today's video we are checking out a couple of brand new power banks from Anker. So we have the Anker Prime 26k power bank, this one right here. This one has a 26,250 milliamp hour capacity and this can output up to 300 watts, which is quite insane. So it doesn't matter what devices you are charging from it, if you are charging one or two laptops and a phone, this can definitely output as much power as you need. This also supports very fast charging, so up to 250 watt charging. That means that if you do charge it at that speed, it can charge from 0 to 50% in about 13 minutes, so insanely fast. Then we have the Anker Prime 20K. This one has a 20,100 milliamp hour capacity. This can output up to 220 watts and the charging input is 100 watts. So of course this one will not charge as fast as this one, but this one is smaller, it's also cheaper and so on. Just before we go any further, I also want to mention that this video is sponsored by Anker, and if you want to check out any of these power banks here, there will be links available in the video's description. So a couple of weeks ago we were on vacation. Of course I brought this one with me because it offers the most capacity for the smallest size. You can see how small this is. Let me show you another power bank from a competitor. They have a similar capacity. I have another one here. Again, similar capacity, but the Anker Prime 26K is smaller. So a couple of weeks ago, we actually went on a short vacation to Romania. We've been on some super cool roads, but of course I brought this one with me because it's so easy to pack in my backpack because it doesn't take that much space. Not to mention it can output enough power for any devices. So if I charge my laptop, if my wife charges her laptop, we can basically charge both laptops at the same time. Plus a phone or a drone or whatever. So if you're a power user, this is definitely a must. Of course, both power banks comply with international TSA standards. So both of these are allowed on planes. We actually have a little marking on the back of each one. So if they ask you about the capacity, you can show them that, but you can take both of these on the plane. Now, for the size and the capacity, this must be the smallest power bank there is. I don't think there is any other power bank with this capacity and this output power that's this small. This one here has a similar capacity and it is much larger, as you can probably see for yourself. So if you're looking for the smallest power bank with the largest capacity that can also output a lot of power, because this can output 220 watts, well, look no further because this one is the one to get. So if you're carrying this in the backpack for a long time, 472 grams is definitely better than the 600 grams from this one or these ones that are much heavier. So very small size and large capacity. As I mentioned earlier, this can recharge with up to 100 watts. I know there will be another product available from Anker. It's called the Anker Prime Charging Base. I haven't got to try it yet. But if you are basically using an 100 watt charger for this, this will recharge from 0 to 50% in about 25 minutes. If you are going to be using that Anker Prime charging base, it will be able to recharge in about 27 minutes to 50%. We have some docking connectors here at the bottom, but again, I haven't got to try that new product quite yet. The Anker Prime 26K will also support that Anker Prime charging base, which I haven't got to try. We have some pins at the bottom here, but as I mentioned earlier, you can charge this with up to 250 watts. So next I want to show you a little charging test. I have a charger that can output 140 watts, another charger that outputs 100 watts. So it'll be about 10 watts off the 250 watts that this can do, but you'll get the idea, and I'll also show you a little test with this one charging. So let's play that little charging test and I will be right back. Now, one thing I find very exciting about these power banks is seeing how fast they can actually recharge. So if you're using two chargers, so both USB-C ports on it, this can recharge with up to 250 watts. Now, I only have an 140 watt charger here and an 100 watt charger here. So first we're gonna plug this one in. So we'll plug it in here. Let's actually bring this closer to the camera so you can see it better. If the camera focuses, all right.
So we'll give it a bit so it speeds up that charging speed. So 103 watts, 111, 118, 125, 131. So it's charging with 140 watts from that first charger. And if we plug in the second one here, dual port fast recharging. So let's see what kind of charging speeds we get. So 140 watts from that one, and let's go back here, and 100 watts from the other one. So very close to its maximum recharging speed. So right now it's pulling in 240 watts. So it's showing that it will be full in about 43 minutes at this charging speed. So quite impressive, because this is a massive power bank that charges in way less than an hour. So it is very exciting for me to see these insane charging speeds on these power banks. So if you're using just one 140 watt charger, of course, it's going to be a bit slower. But if you do have the second charger and you plug it in, it will charge quite fast. So look at that, 240 watts. So it's pulling the exact amount that these chargers can actually output, which is crazy. All right, and we are moving on to our charging test with the Anker Prime 20K. So the biggest difference between the 20K and the 26K here is the charging speed. So this one can do up to 250 watts charging, where this one can only do up to 100 watts charging. So of course, charging this one will be slower. So where you've seen that this one, you can basically plug in two cables, two USB-C cables to charge it from two chargers. Well, this one only works for one. So we'll just plug it in. We'll see what kind of charging speed we get. So it's going up about 35 now, 41 watts, 47, 53, 59, 64. We'll just give it a second till it reaches the maximum 100 watt charging speed. So 98, 99. So I think it's gonna stay around 99 there. So if we click on this button, we can actually see the charging speed. So this charging speed, it will basically take about 25 minutes to charge to 50%, because it's not empty. It's showing about 53 minutes to be full. So it's currently pulling in about 99 watts. So again, if you want to see it like this, you can see it a bit bigger. So that will be the one of the main differences between this one here and our bigger and, well, more special power bank, let's call it. That one will charge faster than this one, but even 100 watts is pretty impressive for a power bank. And as you've seen for yourself, both power banks charge quite fast, but I want to mention that you need a good cable. Not all cables will be able to provide those charging speeds. So talking about cables, you do get these cables in the boxes with each power bank. You also get these carrying pouches. I don't know where the second one is, it's probably in the car somewhere. But basically, if you want to keep this safe, you keep it in here, you put the cable in there, and the power bank, it's nice and safe. But you do need good cables to achieve those output and input speeds. If you have a cheap cable, you will not be able to achieve those speeds. So the cable is also a very important part of achieving those speeds, just in case you're wondering. Taking a closer look at our power banks, they're both built very well. I can't really say that one is better than the other one. They're mostly made out of plastic. We have our ports at the top here. So we have two USB-C ports and a USB-A port that applies on both power banks. So on the Anker Prime 20K, those USB-C ports, one of them could output up to 140 watts. The other one would output 65 watts. Or you can have each one of those USB-C ports outputting 100 watts. So it really depends how you use it. Basically, you could charge two laptops like my MacBook Pro, because that one only pulls about 90 watts.
On the other, on the 26K, those USB-C ports can basically output 140 watts on both of them. So it really depends what kind of devices you plan on powering from this. But the devices that I basically have at home, none of them pull that much power. So I don't have any devices that can pull up to 140 watts. So it is what it is. Only certain laptops can actually pull that much power. Both devices have a screen on the front here. We also have a button on the side on each one of them. So if you click on that button, you can switch in between screens. These also have Bluetooth connectivity and you can connect to them through the Anker app. So from the app there, you can see the charging speed. I mean, you can also see the charging speed, the discharging speed right on the little screen here. But if you want to have a bit more customization done, you would install the app. From the app that you can actually customize the screen. You can even have the screen say whatever letters you want. So in my case, I made this one look like this. But again, you can customize that to your wishes. But the build quality on both power banks is great. So next, what I want to do is show you a couple of discharging tests, because I was charging a couple of laptops, a phone, and so on. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I don't have any devices that can pull 140 watts. The most that I have is my MacBook Pro that pulls about 90 watts. It's a couple of years old now. So let's play those discharging tests basically with this one and with this one, and I will be right back. All right, so let's start by plugging in this Samsung phone here. That will start charging. We'll also plug in this MacBook Pro right here. That one will start charging. And of course, we plugged in that MacBook Air. So now you can see here the output for each port. So the Samsung phone here, it's only pulling. Let's go back to that screen again. So the Samsung phone, it's only pulling about 5 watts. Then the MacBook Pro, it's pulling about 90 watts. And the MacBook Air, about 43 watts. So this is the most that these devices can currently pull. I don't think I've ever seen the MacBook Pro pulling more power than that. And the same for that MacBook Air. So even though the power bank could actually output way more, we just don't have the devices that could pull that much power. So I probably need some newer MacBook Pro so I can max out the output on that power bank. So you can basically charge two laptops and a phone at the same time from this power bank. All right, so next we're gonna be doing a bit of a charging test to the Anker Prime 20K. So the maximum output for this one, as I mentioned earlier, is 220 watts. Now, all these devices here are not gonna be able to pull that much power. So we have an iPhone here. We'll plug this one in first, I guess. So that one will start charging. We plugged in the MacBook Pro. That one can pull about 90 watts. And of course, we also plugged in the MacBook Air. So let's get a bit the power bank a bit closer to the camera so you can see this better. So our MacBook Pro, it's currently pulling about, let's push that button again, 88 watts. The MacBook Air is pulling about 22 watts and the iPhone about 6 watts. So realistically, you can pull double that if we would have the devices that can actually pull that much power. But unfortunately, I just don't have any other devices that charge faster. But if you just want to use this to charge your laptop on the go, no problem whatsoever. This has plenty of output power to power pretty much any laptop out there. So yeah, these are the output speeds that we get. So currently 31 watts for the MacBook Air, about 88 watts for the MacBook Pro, and about 6 watts for that iPhone. As for safety, you have nothing to worry about. Both devices also use Anker's active shield technology, so they will keep themselves cool and safe. If they have to limit the charging or the discharging speed, they will do so they keep themselves safe. So you have nothing to worry about. So if you're looking for a new power bank for your iPhone, for your Samsung phone, for your drone, or any laptop that you may have, definitely consider these two right here. So the way I see it, if you're a professional creator who needs to power multiple high demand devices like laptops or cameras for extended periods off site, then definitely buy the Anker Prime 26K. But if you're just a regular daily power user, maybe a commuter or even a traveler who needs a reliable, powerful, yet more compact option, then definitely get the Anker Prime 20K, because you can easily charge your laptop, your phone, your tablet, headphones from that one. So as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I will leave some links in the video's description. If there are any coupon codes or anything like that, there will be that will be in the video's description as well. Thanks once again, Anker, for sponsoring this video. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll try to answer whatever questions you may have. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys in the next one.